Time to finish up where we left off, but before we get into that part of it, you have another career on board here. I mean, the pulled pork and the coleslaw and everything. Mm-hmm. Is this going to be your side gig in a little while?
Maybe. You know, I really enjoy cooking like this.
Talk to Bruce. He can help you plan for that. You
That's
know?
Right. Absolutely.
Yeah, I'll we've got big plans.
I can eat.
Me too. Yeah. You've brought in smoked meats before, and they're always divine. But this coleslaw, this is your first go at it?
Yeah.
Made from scratch?
Yep, never tried it before, so that's my first
time. Wow, that's perfect. Amazing. Yep. And Bruce brought the pie, of course.
Yep. I was up all night.
Up all night long, shopping for pie. Didn't tell anybody. Now, so you also brought some ideas on what we need to talk about when we sit down to dinner with everyone.
Yeah, I mean, you know, not everybody sits down and goes, okay, everybody, let's start talking about money.
Right.
Right? You don't ever, I mean, that's probably not the best approach to an enjoyable Thanksgiving dinner, right?
Right.
But, you know, inevitably, you know, what pops up is, boy, grandma's looking, you know, she's aging, and, you know, everybody's talking around. And here's what pops up more often than not. I get a lot of calls after Thanksgiving. Hey, we've been thinking about what we're going to do for care, and mom's getting older, and we need to start figuring that out. And so people usually wait till they're older to start thinking about planning for care. What I advocate is, why not have that conversation while you're younger so you can start developing a plan? Mm-hmm. Because planning does pay off, and we covered that extensively during our workshops. That, you know, it doesn't matter where you start now, where are you going to be with a plan when the time comes
right.
and you're going to be in need of a direction on which way the family is going? Because it's usually a family effort, you know, mm-hmm. grandma goes into care or grandma doesn't. And now mom takes a little bit of time, she's helping, dad takes some time, maybe the kids, the adult children, they'll swing by, maybe mow the yard, do her laundry, do some cooking.
Right.
It's kind of a family effort, right?
Yeah.
Well, if you get to the point to where we don't have the ability to provide the quality of life that our grandparent might need, or parent, that could happen, then the decision's gotta be made. Where are we gonna go? What's it gonna cost? It's always the number one thing people consider is, let's look at all these facilities, but what's the cost gonna be?
Is this also a good time where you might, if you already have this sort of plan, to say, this is what's going to be happening, this is what you need to know, either if it happens next week or, you know, 10 years down the road?
Right. People are usually shocked when they go to start talking to a facility, getting ideas. Mm-hmm. They have no clue what's involved with getting either qualified or the cost of, mm-hmm. of items, the cost of you name it. I mean, it all adds up. And people are usually shocked by the numbers.
Yeah.
And then they just start saying, I just don't know what we're gonna do. And then they start making mistakes because they don't have a plan.
Yeah.
And that's a major concern.
They find out Medicare doesn't pay for any of that.
That's right.
And then they also say, well, I'm gonna work until the day I drop, and I'm not going into a nursing home.
Right.
I'm just gonna die in my sleep and everything's gonna be rosy.
Right.
And then no.
Yeah.
Everything's different, and someone can't take care of him or herself, and it changes everything.
The plan will affect a lot of people. It's not bad to have input from those people mm-hmm. as well.
Right. I mean, because we could just spend all of our money and save enough to buy some elephant dung gin,
and then
and we could just go out with a bang.
Let's all have a cocktail and not worry about it.
Bruce, this is the best pie you've ever made.
It's delicious. All right, if you have a financial question for Bruce, visit his website, resourcecenterinc.com, for more information, or email him at bporter@colorton.com next Tuesday, 2 and 6 at the Resource Center.
Yep. See you there.
Coming up, great food. Our friend Alex Webster is here. You may remember him from the 12 Irish Tenors. Now he's an accomplished realtor. How was that transition for him? Stick around to hear the full story. We'll be right back.
I want more coleslaw.
It's good stuff. Mm.